For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008 6 from your Sample Files folder. In order for themes to work their magic, you must get into the habit of using cell styles to format cells based only upon the options available in the current theme. For many years, expert Word users have used styles to quickly produce professional documents. Their mortal sin would be to apply a font size or colour directly to a document. Now that Excel also supports styles, professional Excel users should adopt the same discipline. So I'm going to begin by applying a style to cell A1. So I'll click in cell A1 to make this the active cell. And notice that even though cell A1 now encompasses cells A1 to G1, the cell reference is still simply A1. I'm going to now look for a suitable style for cell A1. To do this, I'll click the Home tab on the ribbon, and in the Styles group, I'll click Cell Styles to bring up the Cell Styles gallery. Now, because this is a gallery, if I hover over a style, such as the Good style, you can see that in the worksheet, the background of the cell has now changed to light green, and the text is shown in dark green. Because this is a title, the best style will probably be in the Titles and Headings section. So I'll hover over each in turn and decide which heading will look best in this worksheet. Well, for me, it's the title style, so I'll click Title to apply the title style to cell A1. Now I'd like a style for my header row, that is, cells A4 to G4. So I'll select cells A4 to G4. Once again, I'll click Home tab on the ribbon, Styles, Cell Styles, in order to bring up the Cell Styles gallery. Once again, I'll most likely find the best style in the Titles and Headings section, so I'll hover over the first style. Well, I can see that this font size is too large, because I can't read the text in cell A4. Let's try Heading 2. This is also too large. But Heading 3 is perfect, so I'll click Heading 3 to apply the Heading 3 style to cells A4 to G4. Now let's look at that note in cell A22. I'll click in cell A22. Once again, Home tab on the ribbon, Styles, Cell Styles, to bring up the Cell Styles gallery. And I can see there's a note style. Let's see how that looks. Yes, the note style looks very good. So I'll have the note style for cell A22. Now I'll apply a background colour to cells A5 to D20. So I select cells A5 to D20. Once again, it's Home tab on the ribbon, Styles, Cell Styles, to bring up the Cell Styles gallery. And when you apply a background colour to a cell with text within it, it's best to stay with one of the 20% accent colours, because the darker colours tend to be rather overwhelming. So I'll select 20% accent 1. When I click, the selected cells have the 20% accent 1 style applied to them. And let's now put a contrasting colour into cells E5 to G20. So I'll select cells E5 to G20. Once again, Home tab on the ribbon, Styles and Cell Styles. And this time, I'll select the 20% accent 2 colour. I click, and the style is applied to the selected cells. Now I'm going to insert a row above row 21. You learned how to do this in lesson 3.1. I select row 21, then right-click and insert to insert a new row. I'm now going to place a total in cell G21. You learned how to do this in lesson 2.3. So I click in cell G21, and then on the Home tab of the ribbon, in the Editing group, I click the Auto Sum button twice. I can see that column G isn't quite wide enough to display the total in cell G21, so I'll click on the intersection of columns G and H and drag slightly to the right to make the cell wide enough. Now I'm going to apply a style to cell G21, so I'll click on cell G21. Once again, Home tab on the ribbon, and in the Styles group, Cell Styles, to bring up the Cell Styles gallery. And I can see that in the Titles and Headings group, there's a style that's just made for totals. It's called the Total Style. So I'll click on the Total Style. And it's now very clear that the value in cell G21 is a total. Because you did things the professional way, using styles instead of directly formatting cells, it's now possible to apply a different theme to the worksheet. Let's see how that's done. I click Page Layout, and in the Themes group, Themes. And here's the Themes Gallery. Now notice that as I hover over each theme, a new font set, color set, and effects set are applied to the worksheet. And if I thought one of these looked better than the previous style, I could click on it, and you can see that the appearance of the worksheet has completely changed. But I think I'll set the theme for this worksheet back to the default office theme, and everything returns to normal. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008 7. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 4.9. Use Cell Styles and Change Themes.